Hey, I'm Fernando. I'm going to show you Raymarching Toolkit for Unity. When you install Raymarching Toolkit, you get this new create menu. I'm going to add an object and I get this sphere. And what's going on is that there's no mesh, there's no polygons, and there's actually a shader running in the background that's using a technique called Raymarching, where you can render 3D shapes only using math. And Raymarching Toolkit lets you use this technology, but without having to do any shader programming. It's all inside of the Unity UI. When I get this new Raymarching object, I can change its radius, I can change its color, and I can change what kind of object I'm gonna render. So instead of a sphere, I'm gonna choose a box. And when I change the object, I actually get a new set of inputs. And all of this, you know, there's no actual mesh generation or anything. All I'm doing is changing the parameters that are going to go into the final shader. And the box that I just chose actually is called a snippet. And if I double click it, I can edit it. And what it's going on here is that the snippets are little pieces of code that tell the shader how to render a surface. You don't have to think about this if you only want to use the UI tools, but if you know a little bit of shader code, you can also use this to make your own kinds of objects. One cool thing that you can do with Raymarching is blend objects together. So I'm going to add another sphere, and I'm going to add this special type called blend. And what's going on is that if I move this object inside of the new blend object, you can see that the surface is blending together in interesting ways. And you can still move all the objects inside it around. And the blend itself also has its own parameters, so I can change the intensity in which the objects blend together. And I can also change what kind of blend is going to happen. So I can use this one called stairs. And what's going to happen is it's going to add all of these ridges wherever two objects are touching each other. Another powerful feature of Raymarching is that you can modify the world in interesting ways. I have this component called a Raymarch modifier. And what I can do is also choose a snippet. And this type of snippet is actually a transformation of the world. So I'm gonna choose twist. And I get these parameters, I can change the angle. And what's going on is that the entire object that I created is twisting around, and that's kind of amazing. Another modifier that's really powerful is called repeat. And what's going to happen is that my object is going to be repeated infinitely, and I can move the scene view camera around and go, you know, very, very far away, and I'm going to still see the same object. And this is happening in real time, so if I change the position of the sphere, I can see that it's been updated in all of the instances. And this is because the way the rendering is being done is there's no such thing as the instance of an object or game objects that are being, you know, rendered as meshes. This is just kind of like a mathematical operation, and it's very easy to say, okay, repeat this over and over and over without really an extra cost for rendering. And, you know, Raymarching Toolkit comes with a lot of examples, and there's all these new amazing different ways of using these basic tools to create scenes, to render fractals, to make backgrounds for your games. So I hope you like it.